Hello, Brev! Oh my god, have you still not tidied up from the stag do? Get up, you lazy sod! Oh, you said you'd be ready by the time I got here!
I'm ready!
No, you're not, you're a mess! It's not a pyjama party!
I'm dressed perfectly fine for what I've got planned today.
No, you're not. You look a slob. But then again, you mostly do.
I can't be insulted, you know. I'll have you know that I have got hidden depths that you know nothing about. Anyway, I've got other plans today.
No, you haven't. You're just being a nuisance. Now, get yourself shaved and put your new suit on. You look good in that.
Don't boss me around. I've got a mind of my own, you know.
Really? I've never known. Just remember that it's your best friend's wedding in just 4 hours. So stop messing around and get ready.
And don't try and intimidate me either. I'm immune to your threats. After all, I've seen you naked.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, that's what they say, isn't it? If someone tries to intimidate you, you just imagine them naked and then it doesn't work. And I don't have to imagine.
When have you seen me naked?
Now, that would be telling, wouldn't it?
Oh, my God, you're a perv, you know that. Spying on your sister in the park.
In the park? You were naked in the park? Come on, what were you up to?
That's got nothing to do with what we were talking about.
Yeah, I know, but this is way more interesting.
I'm telling you, Steve, to drop it.
Well, like you did in the park.
Drop it!
All right. Look, all I'm saying is if I'm his best mate, then surely I should be the best man. But in the park, though.
I won't tell you again, right?
All right.
So that's what all this fuss is about. You're not the best man. Well, Becky's got a brother, so naturally he should be the best man.
It's not natural at all. Look, up until 2 weeks ago, he was saying I was the best man, and then suddenly I'm not. Oh, Becky's brother Mike doesn't even want to do it anyway.
Well, his mother does, so that's the end of the argument. Now come along and stop being a spoilt kid. I need to get ready.
But you're going to be a bridesmaid, and Becky's got a sister.
Oh, you are such a dickhead. You can have as many bridesmaids as you like, but you can only have one best man, and that's her brother, right? So come on, can we please get on? I need to get ready. I've got to get dressed, I've got to get my hair done. So stop acting like a spoilt kid and get ready.
Oh, it's all right for you dressed up like Tinkerbell threw up on you. And it's all right for bloody brother Mike in his top hat and tails. I don't get so much as a buttonhole. It's not fair. This was supposed to be our special day. But Becky's rotten football of a mother's gone and ruined it all. You know, if us blokes had organised this, we wouldn't have any of these problems. No, how many have got to organise in about 2 weeks? How long has it taken you girls? About 2 years? And you've still made a mess of it.
Don't make me laugh. If it was down to you men, it would have been down to the pub for half a dozen pints, fall into the registry office, mumble the words, and then back to the pub.
Oh, it's the day I've dreamed about since I was a little boy. Come on, you'd still be just as married, wouldn't you? And after all, they've been living together for 2 years. They're hardly a couple of love-struck virgins, are they?
Right. Well, you can please yourself. Go or stay. I really don't care. I've got a lot to do. I only came round to help you because I know how useless you are. But now, you can please yourself because I am off.
Oh, don't go getting shirty. I'm just expressing my natural disappointment at being let down. And it's not just me, you know. It's my best mate Stuart who's been let down as well. And what about inflatable Ingrid here? She's had her outfit picked out for weeks. You know, being my sister, I thought you'd understand, but obviously, I was wrong.
Look, I'm sorry, bro. I know you're disappointed, but we can make the best of it, can't we? Well, for Stuart's sake.
I don't know. It won't be easy. It won't be the same.
No, I'm afraid not. Once Stuart's married, things will change. There'll be no 3 times down the pub each week. He'll have responsibilities. There could soon be the patter of tiny feet.
Oh, fantastic! Are they getting a dog?
No! Children!
Oh, now you're really depressing me. Oh, I'm going back to bed.
Oh, come on, Steve. I've got a lot to do. Stop being an arsehole and get ready.
Look, I've told you I'm not going, and I'm not. All my mates are going to be there, and what are they going to say? They all expect me to be best man. It's going to be so embarrassing, so I'm not going to there.
Well, you could have been an usher. Mrs. Radley offered you that, didn't she?
Oh, yes. Mrs. Ratbag did insult me, yes. Well, I think you could just about manage showing everybody to their seat, she said, in that patronising way she has. Well, no, thank you very much. I've got my pride, you know. Who are you ringing?
Mrs. Radley.
Oh, for Christ's sake, not her.
Well, it is her that sent me here. She said Stuart was very upset and I was to get you there by hook or by crook. So now I don't know what to do. Oh, hello, Mrs. Radley. Yeah, he won't come. Well, that's what he says. Well, of course I've tried to persuade him. She wants to talk to you.
Forget it. I've said all I'm going
to
say.
Oh, come on, Steve. Just talk to her. We'll be here all day. Steve, please. Yeah, he won't speak to you. Well, he's disappointed. Well, I don't think calling him names is going to help, is it? Look, I just don't see what I can do. No, we are not all retarded. Oh, and I'll tell you something too. I won't be there either. You're right, she's not a rat bag.
Well said, Jude. That told her.
Well, that's all very well, but we can't let Stuart down, can we?
Why not? As far as I'm concerned, it's all his fault. I mean, he should have stood up to Becky and her rotten mother. God, that bloke is gutless.
Well, you're right, but it is a shame. I'm rather fond of Stuart. We've known him since we were kids. Who the hell could that be?
Oh, God. It's not her, is it? The bride's mother from hell, Mrs. Ratbag.
Not unless she flew here on her broomstick. I just rang her at home.
I wouldn't put it past her. Now, Jude, think. Have you ever seen her look in the mirror? Does she have a reflection? Okay, look, Jude. There's some stale garlic bread in the kitchen. Rub it on your neck. It might stop her biting. Oh, thank God. It's only you. It's all right, Jude. It's just the blushing bride.
Hello, Becky. Should you be at home getting your dress on?
I would be, if it weren't for your stupid brother. So tell me, Stephen Cotton, why are you trying to ruin my wedding day?
Oh, well, I'll tell you, Rebecca Ratbag. I don't have to come to your wedding if I don't want to, so there.
What did you call me?
Rebecca Radley.
No, you didn't. You called me Ratbag.
Oh, it was just a spit slip of the tongue.
Yeah, that's right. That's what he calls your mother, not you.
You call my mother Ratbag?
No. No, I usually call her rotten old nasty Ratbag. I'm not alone. Most people who have met her even briefly call her worse.
Well, I can see it's no good talking to you, the mood you're in.
Quite right. I have said all I'm going to say. I'm not going, and that is that.
You do realise Stuart's in a real state because of you. Come on, there must be something we can do.
Oh, look, you're clever. I'm sure you'll work something out.
Look, let's calm down. I'm sure there's a way we can sort this out.
Don't see how. Yeah, unless we can nobble the old rat bag until after the wedding. Come on, Jude, you've got an evil mind. Well, can you figure something, can't you? Hang on. Maybe we could arrange to have her kidnapped till after the wedding. Yeah, but who would dare lay hands on her? She could perhaps turn you into a frog.
This is all just because you're not best man, isn't it?
You're quite right.
Well, my brother's going to be best man.
Yeah, but he doesn't want to be, does he?
Well, who said so?
He told me himself.
Well, I'm sure he didn't.
He did, Becky. I was there. He feels embarrassed by the whole thing.
Well, even so, my mother wants him to be best man.
And there we have the heart of the problem. Oh, it's your mother. You're all frightened of your mother. It's just your wedding day. You should stand up for what you want. It's your special day. And Stuart, somebody should grow up here.
I don't mean to interfere, Becky, but why do you always give away to your mother all the time?
She's a difficult person to say no to. And Well, she says she's paying for it, so she's entitled to have her say.
Well, don't you get a say?
Yeah, but it's really difficult. I mean, she just doesn't listen to anybody. And, you know, she's my mum. It's a big day for her as well. I just don't want to upset her.
But she's upset Stuart, and on your wedding day. So who's more important, your mother or your future husband? You're going to have to make a choice.
Well, that's a no-brainer between my old mate Stuart and the old ratbag.
Will you please stop saying that?
Yes, Steve, if you haven't got anything constructive to say, just shut up.
Well, pardon me for talking. I mean, remember that I'm the injured party here.
You're not injured at all. You're just worried about your stupid pride. It's Becky and Stuart that are the losers in this sorry argument.
You'll never guess what Stuart said the other night. He said, why don't we just go off somewhere and get married quietly? Somewhere like a registry office. And I think he meant it.
You know, I think that's a brilliant idea. We've still got time to organise it, and then I could be best man. Of course, we've got to make sure the old rat bag doesn't find out, or she'd ruin everything again. You know, I think this could be the way to go.
If you've got nothing useful to say, just shut up.
Pardon me, that was a useful suggestion.
Becky, I think the answers to your problems lie with your mother.
Well, in that case, I'm definitely going back to bed.
Sit down.
I'm sitting.
Good. Now, Becky, what do we do?
I don't know. I think it's too late to do anything now. I should have stood up to her ages ago.
At last, the worm turns.
It's a bit uncalled for, Steve.
No, he's quite right. I mean, none of the family have ever been able to stand up against her. Dad's been under the hood for the last 35 years. He stands up to her every now and again.
35 years? My God, I would have shot myself. 34 and a half years ago. But now Stuart's under the old bag's control as well. Oh my God, I shouldn't have been worried about not being the best man. I should have been worried about soon meeting the groom.
Are you comparing me to my mother?
Well, if the pointy hat fits.
Okay, let's calm down. This isn't getting anywhere. Steve, please try to keep it.
Disagrees with everything I say. Right, all right, okay. Where is he?
I don't know. I think he's at home getting changed, but why don't you ring him and find out where he is?
Wasn't he there when you left this morning?
You don't stay in the same place as your groom the night before the wedding, do you?
Don't you? Why the hell not?
Because it's tradition. He's not even supposed to see her until she's walking down the aisle in her wedding dress. It's romantic.
Oh, God, romance. Because you women, you make everything so complicated. Now, if it's down to me, it'll all be done online.
Stephen,
click a button on Facebook.
We don't want to know about your stupid ideas of romance. You are about as romantic as a cold sausage. So ring him. Now!
All right. But I will have you know that I can be as romantic as the next man when I want to be. But it just so happens I don't often want to be, so there. Right, what shall I tell my mate? Run away and join the Foreign Legion? Throw himself under a bus?
For God's sake, Steve, just tell him that you're happy for Mike to be best man and that you will be there as an usher for him on his special day. And please stop making silly jokes, you're upsetting Becky.
Sorry, Becky, but happy? I'm pretty far from happy. Look, I'll tell him I'm going to the wedding, but under protest.
You will tell him what I said, and you will be there for him on his special day.
You've got me hair. All right, okay. But once this is all over, him and your rotten mother are getting a right mouthful.
Well, that's fair enough. But today, you'll be all sweetness and light, and you'll keep your nasty mouth shut. Right?
Yeah, all right.
Now, ring him.
Who?
Who do you bloody well think, Stuart?
Is he always like this?
Oh, no. Sometimes he's really stupid.
There's no need to get abusive. Oh, two women at once, it confuses me. Come on. Look, there's no answer. He's not there.
He must be. He's not there. This is all your fault, Steve. Why are you going to be such a prat?
That's a little bit uncalled for.
Thank you, Jude.
No, shut up. You are a prat. I thought, though, Becky, we'd established that your mother was responsible for this cock-up.
Well, yeah. She started it, but because of your stubbornness, you've more or less ruined my wedding day. Come on, Steve. Help us. I know how fond you are of Stuart.
That is true. They've known each other since they were kids. And Steve loves him.
Do you not love him?
Yeah, you do.
No, I do not. We're mates. It's something different.
Whatever you call it. You wouldn't know it, Becky, but he is such a coward.
I'm not. Why do you keep saying that? Well, what's it got to do with anything anyway?
If you shut up for a minute, you find out. I'll tell you something, Becky. When we were kids, I used to beat him up. He's such a wimp. But when they were teenagers, three football hooligans had Stuart on the floor and they were kicking him. What do you think our cowardly wimp did? He ran at them like a maniac. He laid two out and the third ran away. And if that isn't love, I don't know what is.
Will you stop saying that I love him? Look, he's my mate. He's my best mate. Oh, God, you women, you wouldn't understand, but blokes don't love each other. It's just something different. And anyway, you never used to beat me up.
Oh, yes, I did. I used to have you on the floor screaming for mercy.
Well, I used to let you win. And anyway, you're older than me and bigger back then. And from behind, you still are. So, Becky, I'm sorry if I've caused any trouble, but my feelings were hurt.
I know. I'm sorry I blamed all this on you, Steve, but I do love him. I'm just really worried. I'll try his mobile. Switched off. He's always bloody doing it. He's such a bloody idiot.
Yes, he is a bloody idiot. So let's have no more talk of me loving him, shall we? Now, let's work out where he could have got to. Where does he normally go when he's upset?
He goes to find you.
Can't imagine why.
Because I'm his best mate, okay? But obviously he hasn't in this case. Or perhaps he has.
Where have you been? You're in so much trouble, mate.
I'm in the shit, mate.
You can say that again.
Becky! Oh! What are you doing here?
I came here looking for you!
Where have you been? I've just been walking around and thinking. Anyway, I'm here now, so there's no need for you to be upset.
Excuse me, but exactly why are you in the old smelly stuff?
Oh, Bex. I'm sorry, babes, but I've really done it now.
Done what?
Something terrible.
You do something terrible? That'll be the day. Come on, tell us what it is.
I can't. So embarrassed.
Come on, I'm sure it's not that bad.
It is. Really it is. I'm afraid I've told your mother to get stuffed.
Fantastic! Oh, well done, mate. I didn't think you had it in you.
No, I'm sure you must have just been provoked in some way. I mean, it's not really a character for you, is it? You're so polite.
Oh, she'd make a saint swear, the old maggot.
Oh, Steve, will you be quiet?
Look, I'm just sticking up for my mate. Come on, give us all the gory details, leave nothing out.
Well, I was at home, and there was this banging and shouting on the front door. I thought there'd been an accident or something, so I answered it, and it was your mother, and she went, "Where is she?" Oh, I went, "Who? You know bloody well who. Becky! Becky!" I said, "She's not here." She went, "You know all this day to be perfect. You and that layabout friend of yours have done all you can to ruin my perfect day."
Layabout? Layabout? Does he mean me?
What other layabout friend has he got? Go on, Stuart.
Well, I was quite cross, but I tried to be reasonable. And I said, "It's not your perfect day. It's meant to be mine and Becky's." "Who's paying for it?" she said. "Who's worked their fingers to the bone for the last 12 months? This wedding will go the way I've arranged, or there will be no wedding. I will forbid her to have anything more to do with you. I can't say I was particularly impressed when she brought you home in the first place." "So, my fine feathered friend," she said. "What do you have to say about that?" I'm afraid it was then that I sort of lost my temper.
Well, it's about time somebody did. Come on, what did you say?
Well, I looked at her and I said, "You can get stuffed, missus! And as for this wedding, you can stick it right up your..."
"Well, don't stop there! Stick it where?"
"You know."
"You didn't. Not up her ass." "You did!" "You can stick it up her ass. Stick it up her ass. Oh, you've always been the same, mate. Slow to anger, but when you do, watch out. Up her ass."
"I'm sorry, Bex. I didn't mean it about the wedding. Honestly, it just made me so cross it sort of came out."
"It's all right. Don't blame yourself. I know what she's like. What are we going to do now?"
"Well, I'm happy to say Steve has agreed to be an usher, so maybe we can go on with the wedding as planned."
Yeah, I don't know about that anymore. I mean, now Stuart has finally stood up for himself, I'm not sure I want to fall in with the old baggage's plans. I mean, I've got to stick up for my mate, haven't I?
"I don't believe it. So we're right back where we were this morning. I'm getting really fed up of you, Steve. I wish you'd make your mind up whether you're coming or not."
"Now, hang on a second. It's not really Steve's fault. No, I'm afraid the fault with all of this does lie with your mother, I'm afraid, babes. She's determined that we will have the wedding the way she wants, or not at all."
"Well, can't we just go along with her until after the wedding, and then we can do as we please?"
"Ah, that's called appeasement, that is. That's how Hitler came to power, everyone kowtowing to him. Started the Second World War, that did."
"Are you comparing my mother to Hitler?"
"All I'm saying is that when she talks to me, I do get this overwhelming urge to go, 'Yab on!'"
"Stuart, say something! I hope you don't agree with him!"
"Yeah, well, look, what can he say? Come on, you know it's true. If she could, she'd have me in front of a firing squad."
"Oh, now you're going too far."
"Really? Tell you something, you'd be right there beside me. I don't think much to Stuart's chances either."
"Look, mate, this isn't helping anything. All I want to do is get this day out of the way and get to the end of it with me and Becky married. Nothing else matters. Not even letting that old rat bag... Not even letting Mrs. Radley have her own way. Now, if you're my mate, and I know you are, you'll support me on this, won't you?"
"All right. But you're making a big mistake. Look, you've got to start as you mean to go on. Once she realises she can get on top of you, that is it, mate, for the rest of your married life."
"Yeah, but he'll have Becky to support him. That's right, isn't it, Bex?" "Bex?"
"Yep, and that's the amount of support you're going to get from her. And her dad."
"Look, mate, come on. I just want to get this bloody wedding out of the way and get on with the rest of our lives."
"So that's how you feel about our wedding, is it? Well, glad I know now before it's too late that we're married.
I didn't mean it. Come on, Steve. Help us out here.
Fat chance.
Shut up, Steve!
Oh, fine, that's all right. That's it. I've said all I'm going to say. You can sort it out for yourself. Now, I give up trying to help you people.
Good. Now, Stuart, we'll do as you say. We'll go on with the wedding as planned. There'll be plenty of time once you're married to speak to the mother. Are we agreed?
I think that's the best idea. I'm really sorry, babe, but I'll make it up to you, I promise.
I know you will.
Oh, for God's sake, that's all the same, isn't it? Women get their way by promising sex. It's not fair. It's underhand. It's sexist. And no one ever tries it with me.
I thought you weren't going to say another word. Right, so maybe we should go start getting ready. That is, if we are still all going. Well, are we?
Yes, I suppose so.
Hello? Hi, Mummy. I'm just at Steve's flat. Well, because Stuart's here. No, but we're just discussing the wedding. No, just a few last-minute details. I know it's all organised. No, you don't need to come round. No, I said you needn't come round, Mummy. I'll be home in a few minutes. Yes, I know the clock is ticking.
Idiot's not a bomb ticking!
I said I'm coming. Oh, for goodness sake, Mummy, I'm not your child! No, I'm not getting cross, I'm sorry. Of course I mean it. I'll be home soon. Bye.
Well, that was a close shave. Oh, I don't know about you lot, but I could do with a drink. Oh, how about you, mate?
Oh, you bet. I could drink a barrel full.
Is that wise at this time of the morning?
Who cares? I need it to calm my nerves.
Enjoy it while you can, mate. Once you're married, you're going to be too busy looking after the kids to come down the pub with me.
Who said so?
She did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, I suppose I kind of did. Oh, shut up, Steve!
Hang on. I can't see why you're getting so upset about this whole wedding thing, mate. To be honest, I didn't think you gave a bugger about being the best man.
You know, well, normally I might not, but see, the thing is, I kind of invited someone to the wedding as my plus one, and I made this big deal about being best man. You know, best man to my best mate. And now I'm going to look a right tit, aren't I? Just an usher. So, I just told her it was all off. Told her I'd gone down with a lurgy and taken to my bed, which is why I'm still in my robe. And once you lot have all cleared off, she's coming round here to minister to me.
You're lying. There's no way you've got a bird.
Well, don't say it like that. After all, you've got one.
Who? Oh, yeah. Who is she? Not that bird from the fish shop. You know, the one with the squint.
No. Quite incredibly with a little more taste than that.
Well, you went out with her a few times.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. I saw you. Well, even though you made her wear a hoodie and legged it when you saw me coming.
Oh, this has got nothing to do with who I'm bringing to the wedding.
So all of this is so you can save face in front of some tart?
Jude, I will thank you not to call Sonia a tart, if you'd please.
Sonia? Not Sonia Temple from the college?
Oh, yes. That's wiped the smug smile off your face, hasn't it? Ah, so what do you make of that, smartass?
My word, Sonia Temple. When we were at school, we were so overawed by her. But, hang on, she is absolutely gorgeous. Oh, and she's intelligent. What's she seeing you?
Well, thank you for that vote of confidence. I'll have you know there are people out here who do find me attractive, as hard as it is for you lot to believe.
Yeah, of course there is. So why have you kept it a secret for so long then?
Oh, for God's sake, I haven't kept it a secret, but all anyone's spoken about for the last 6 months has been this bloody wedding. I haven't been able to get a word in edgeways. So I just thought I'd leave it as a surprise for the wedding day. And I guess that's ruined now, isn't it? Look, will you not please clear off? I've got to get to my bed to be ministered to.
Can't believe it. Sonia Temple, the Sonia Temple, is coming round to your bedroom to minister to you. Like I was saying, when we were at school, we were so overawed by her. God, we wouldn't even talk to her.
Well, I'll tell you this much, mate. I do more than talk to her now.
Oh, now I understand that weekend in Cromer you were so mysterious about.
Oh. Hang on. You had a dirty weekend in Cromer with Sonia Temple.
Oh, yes, it was fantastic. You know, that's the first time I ever showed her my lightsaber. Oh. Now, once she got her set eyes on it, she couldn't keep her hands off it.
You know he's probably talking about his real lightsaber?
She must have played with it for hours.
I hope he's talking about his real lightsaber.
Look, so now you lot know what's going on. Do you mind clearing off?
Forget it. Not until we've sorted this best man situation out.
But it's impossible. Don't you see? I'm a... I'm a death door. I won't recover for days. Or even weeks.
Well, let me tell you this. You will make a miraculous recovery. There's still time. Bring her. And tell her to put her glad rags on.
Oh.
Because she's going to a wedding. Right.
Please, mate.
Oh. You do realise that I have got Sonia Temple coming round here to my bedroom to mop my fevered brow.
Please, mate.
Oh, all right. God. As long as you realise what I'm giving up here. I wouldn't do this for just anyone, you know.
I understand what a sacrifice it is. I'm not sure I could do it. Not even for you.
Yeah, just as long as you realise what I'm giving up.
So who is this Sonia Temple?
Let's not talk about that now, eh? Just be thankful he's not bringing in favour of Ingrid as his plus one. Now, I think we all need a bloody drink.
No, not for me, Jude, thanks.
If anyone needs a drink today, it's you, the poor bloody bride.
No, I'm sure brides never drink on their wedding day.
Are you joking? Have you never seen you've been framed? Brides are always getting drunk and falling on their backside. It's my favourite bit.
Drink this, it's medicinal. And don't worry, I'll be holding your train, I won't let you fall over.
Yeah, and who's going to be holding you up? Hang on, I'll save you a job. Shut up, Steve! Oh, for God's sake, who's that? Any more people, and we can have the wedding here. She's here!
Who's here?
Mrs. Ratbag!
What's going on? Hello? Hello? Let me in!
It's Mrs. Radley! What's it? She's come in!
Take the chain off and let me in immediately!
I left the chain on!
You left Mummy on the landing? Steve, how could you?
Oh, don't let her in!
Hang on,
Mrs. Radley!
Give me a head start first!
Hello! Let me in at once! Take this chain off!
Oh, hello, Mrs. Radley! Do come in!
Right! What is going on?
Well, come on, somebody say something. Have you all been struck dumb? Rebecca, what have you got to say for yourself? You know you shouldn't be here with your intended on the day you get married. This is all you're doing, isn't it? I specifically told you you should not see Rebecca until she is walking down the aisle in the beautiful dress which I incidentally have paid for. Now, didn't I say that?
Yes, well, but...
No buts. I specifically told you you shouldn't see Rebecca until you're in church. Now, didn't I say that?
But Mrs. Radley, it's a bit more complicated than that.
Will you be quiet? This has nothing to do with you. Well, I asked you a question.
It's Steve.
I might have known that retard had something to do with it. If you are going to marry my daughter, you have got to learn to choose your friends more in keeping with our position in society. Where is he?
Oh, he's just nipped out for a moment.
Well, he answered the door to me and then ran off like the cowardly cur that he is. Why didn't he take the chain off? I see. Too embarrassed to answer. Right. Come along, Rebecca. Let's get you home and into that wedding dress. We've got a lot to do today. Chop, chop, chop.
But Mrs. Radley, I think Stuart and Becky have got some problems they need solving.
I thought I told you to be quiet. Any problems they have been caused by you and your moronic brother. This is a family affair, so keep out of it. I shan't tell you again.
No, I won't keep out of it. You should listen to your daughter.
How dare you suggest I don't know how to listen to my daughter? You wouldn't understand the close, loving bond I have with her. Isn't that right, Rebecca? Rebecca, did you hear me?
Well,
you see, perfect understanding between mother and daughter. There always has been, ever since she was born, hasn't there, darling? Our house is full of love. Isn't that so, my sweet?
Mrs. Radley?
Now, Stuart, in a couple of hours, you can call me Mummy.
What?
I said soon you'll be able to call me Mummy. Or Mother, if you prefer. I don't like Mum. It's so common. What do you think?
If it's all the same to you, I think I'd rather call you Mrs. Radley.
Oh, well. I'll leave that up to you. Never let it be said that I am difficult to get on with. Now, did you want to say something?
Did I? Oh, yes. Now, you see, Steve, he's a little upset about not being the best man.
Yes, and what of it? It's all been arranged now. My son will be best man at my daughter's wedding, as arranged by me, and, of course, her father. There can be no changes now. I can assure you I've taken everybody's feelings into consideration when making these arrangements. Becky will agree, won't you, Rebecca?
Well... No, Mother.
I beg your pardon, young lady.
She said no, which means she doesn't think you've taken everybody's feelings into consideration. That's right, isn't it, Bex?
Is she right, Rebecca?
Well, Mother, it seems some people think that you might have been a little insensitive to some people's feelings.
Me? Insensitive? I cannot believe it. I have worked my fingers to the bone organising the most perfect wedding day for my daughter, whom I love dearly. I have spared no expense. I have even had crosswords with your father about my generosity. And now I find it's all in vain. You're all ganging up against me. Vicki, you've broken your mother's heart.
What's going on?
Steve! I've made Mummy cry!
Really? Well done!
You! This is all
I'm not used to being thwarted, especially by a nasty little turd like you. I will not stand for this complaint.
Don't you lunatic! Help! Get her off me! Stuart, help! And you! Everyone!
Let me go! I've not finished with him yet!
Mother, what are you saying? You're not normally such a violent person!
Well, I am now!
Now, let's all calm down and talk about this wedding in a proper manner.
Oh, don't tell us. Tell that mad old baggy. She's the one causing the problems.
Oh, I will.
Ah! Keep her away from me.
It would help if you would keep quiet, Steve.
I don't see why.
Because if you don't, I will give you a bloody good hiding.
All right, let's all have a go at me. I mean, anyone would think I wasn't the one in the wrong here, not her. Look at her, she wants locking up.
Shut up, Steve.
Oh, Mummy, don't cry. I'm sorry. We're all sorry, aren't we?
I'm not sorry. Well, I'm not.
Steve, please.
I'm bloody sorry. I'm doubly bloody sorry. Oh, God, I'm so sorry. How can you ever forgive me? Will that do?
That's the best we're going to get.
So you're all sorry, are you? For being so nasty to me?
Yeah. Oh, good, right. We can get on with the wedding the way I can.
I don't believe this.
That's it. I give up. She is immovable.
Nice that we can solve our differences in a calm and reasonable manner. Now, we've got a lot to do. And are you wearing that suit?
What?
Oh, well, I suppose it will have to do. But I do hope you're going to have a shave. We do want to keep up appearances, don't we? Off you go.
Don't believe you! What's wrong with this thing calling
so
me a
good,
turd?
Steve. Now you see what she's really, really like.
Beg your pardon, Rebecca. You really are a most ungrateful girl. Most girls would be delighted to have a mother who takes all the work and worry of the wedding off their shoulders. I'm too nice, that's my trouble. It always has been. I sometimes wonder why I try, but then I know. It's because I have love in my heart. Not just for my family, but for all mankind.
Bloody hell! Yeah, I'm sure as soon as you cut your clogs, the Pope will be straight over to canonise you. Yeah, I can see it now. Saint Marge.
Marge? Marge? I was christened Marjorie. It's only the plebeians of the world who shorten it to Marge. Still, what can we expect from you, the dregs of humanity?
Dregs? And what do you mean by that?
I wouldn't bother, Steve.
You see,
no point.
Even your sister agrees.
I agree to what?
Well, that your brother is, shall we say, socially handicapped.
Did you
I think that's the kindest way I can put it.
Do you hear this, mate? Do you really want to be part of a family that she's involved with?
Look, mate, all I want to do is get bloody married and get off to the Seychelles. If that means letting the old crone have her own way, then so be it.
Beg your pardon, young man. You will have to mend your ways once you're a member of our family. That sort of language will not do.
Yes. I'm sorry, Mrs. Radley. But time is getting on and I'm a little impatient. I do apologise.
Well, that's all right, Stuart. I realise these are pressured times, and we'll say no more about it. Just watch your language, now that you've apologised.
No, Stuart! You shouldn't be apologising. Mother should be. Well, you never apologise, do you, Mother?
Well, I will, my dear.
When?
Well, if ever I do anything wrong, I suppose.
Your husband must have the patience of Job.
Her husband must have the brain the size of a pea to be married for another
35 years. My husband and I have been perfectly married.
Will you all be quiet? The door was open. I hope you don't mind. Well, I could hear you all outside on the street. I wondered what was going on. I hope there isn't a problem with the wedding.
There's no problem with the wedding, mate. The problem is your wife.
I can't imagine what the problem might be.
Can't you? Well, you're the only one who can't, mate. I tell you, she came in here, she threw me on the sofa, she started hitting me, and she called me a turd. If these people hadn't dragged her off, she'd have done some serious damage. Mate, I do not know how you have survived being married to her for 35 years. She wants locking up and the key throwing away.
Is this true, Marjorie?
Roland. Can you imagine me resorting to physical violence, really? I've always abhorred anything physical.
I can believe that. I don't know how these two had three children. It must have been immaculate conception.
Oh, Steve! Will you just shut up? Mr. Radley, it is true what Steve says.
I'm sure
your wife did attack him.
No, I'm sure this cannot be true. Is it, Becky?
Well, yes. No. I just know that I'd like to get this day out the way and be married, wouldn't we, Stuart?
Come on, let's get this straight, Rebecca. Did your mother attack Steve or not? That's a perfectly simple question.
Rebecca? Think very carefully before you answer that question.
Look, she's giving her the evil eye. That's not fair, that is.
Would you please be quiet, Steve? I cannot see my wife resorting to any kind of physical violence.
Quite right, Roland, you tell me. Right, we've got a lot to do today. Your suit looks very nice, dear. I think I chose these suits very well indeed. Right, come along, everybody. Got a lot to do. Let's be off, chop chop.
I'm sorry, everybody, but it really is just easier to go along with Mummy's plans.
Yes, that's right. We're going to have a beautiful day.
Well, I, for one, I'm not going to be part of any wedding that she's planned. Sorry, mate. I just can't do it.
Now, Stephen. I thought we'd sorted all this out. So you just stop being a silly billy. Everybody else is happy with the arrangements. So let's just act our age and stop all this nonsense. Going to have a lovely day, thanks mainly to my efforts.
I think Stuart said it best when he said, "Get stuffed, you old rat bag!"
You turd! Yes! I say, turd, you seem determined to ruin my plans. Well, I'm not gonna
I'm amazed. I mean, you've always had a quick temper, but never violent. What has come over you?
Him. The worm. That's what's come over me. I have never met anybody so irritating or annoying.
I can understand that, and I should know. But that still doesn't account for you attacking him.
You're quite right, Judith. I'm appalled, Marjorie, by your conduct. There can be no excuse for the kind of behaviour I've just witnessed.
Oh, can't there? Well, I'll tell you something, Mr. Roland Sodding Radley. I've just about had it up to here with you and your sanctimonious behaviour. If it was left to you, everybody would just do as they liked. I'm the only one who keeps any order. You can't rely on you for discipline. You're spineless. There, I've said it. I've been meaning to say it for years. So you can put that in your pipe and smoke it. Not not that you'd ever smoke a pipe. Oh, no, far too manly. Lollipops! That'd be your tipple.
No, what are you saying? Daddy, she doesn't mean it.
Oh, yes, I do mean it. I have worked my fingers to the bone. I have lain awake nights, wondering how best to serve my family. And now it comes down to this. All of you ganging up against me. Well, I may as well end it all. I do all this with love in my heart. And where has it got me? What thanks do I get? None. Well, you can be thankful I haven't got a gun, or I would end it all.
Oh, if that's your problem, just hang on. Mr. Jones next door's got a 12.
No! Oh,
mate, you're not helping anything. Just stop it.
It helps me.
No, I think Stuart's right, Stephen. Perhaps it would be better if you remained quiet. Your voice does seem to upset my wife, although I do understand your irritation.
Oh, you understand his irritation, but you ignore mine.
Ignore? It's hard to ignore you, missus, when you're beating me round the head with inflatable Ingrid.
I quite agree, Steve. I'm sorry, my dear, but he is absolutely right. I don't know what came over you, behaving in such a common fashion. We've always said there's no room in our lives for violence.
There comes a time, Roland, when all else fails, that one must reluctantly, and of course with love in one's heart, give somebody a damn good thumping for their own good.
Oh, do you really believe that, do you?
Yes, I do. I've tried everything to persuade that to come around to my way of thinking, but it's all to no avail. Look at him. I think the only way to get through to him is by giving him a damn good belting, so there.
And you really believe that?
Certainly. It is my philosophy. It is the only recourse. Of course, I know you won't approve, but then you're a wimp. I stand before you in a dress, but figuratively speaking, I wear the trousers in our family.
Really? Well, I suppose you're right. I've let you down, Marjorie. I've always tried to be a gentle and reasonable man, but I know that can sometimes be seen as a sign of weakness. I'm not a weak man, Marjorie, but I can understand what you say. I suppose I should have put my foot down years ago. I'm sorry, Rebecca, I apologise, and to you, Stuart, for allowing your mother to go against your wishes for the wedding. Perhaps it's not too late.
What do you mean by that?
I'll show you, my dear, but just to be sure how you feel, you did say that when all else fails and reason and compromise no longer work, that physical violence is the only recourse. That is your philosophy. Is that right?
You saw it yourself.
Oh, yes, thank you, Stephen. Do you think you can do me a favour?
Depends what it is.
Oh, it's quite simple. Have you got a plimsoll?
Plimsoll? Oh, God, you mean a trainer. Nobody wears plimsolls anymore.
No, I don't think a trainer would be suitable for what I have in mind. No, I don't think so. No, that would be suitable. There must be something.
Would this do?
Yes, that would be ideal. Yeah.
When you have quite finished, Roland, we have got a wedding to attend to. All this nonsense with trainers and flip-flops. Do you know, sometimes I think you're losing your mind. It's a good job somebody has their priorities right. Now put that stupid flip-flop down and let's be going. And that goes for the rest of you too.
Just a moment, my dear. I've decided that Becky and Stuart will have the wedding they want. Stephen will be the best man.
Never!
Now, just you be quiet. Be quiet, I won't tell you again. No, just you listen for a change. Stephen will be the best man, just as he always should have been. We will not be wearing these ridiculous suits. Nobody wanted them apart from you. And any other changes that Becky and Stuart want for the wedding, you will agree to, or else.
Or else what? You wouldn't dare.
Daddy, you wouldn't.
Well, it's like Christmas and my birthday's all come at once.
So, what's it to be then, my dear?
Roland, you are making yourself look ridiculous. What on earth do you think you're going to do with that?
Well, I thought I'd put you over my knee and lift up your skirt and give you six of the best.
Roland, will six be enough? Just asking. Carry on, Roland.
Daddy, I don't think you should do this.
Well, just you be quiet.
No, she was only trying to help.
Please be quiet, Rebecca. Please be quiet.
Stuart, tell her to shut up.
Yes.
Shh. As you all know, I've tried to be polite and reasonable. But I love my daughter and I want her and Stuart to have the wedding they've wanted. We've all tried to reason with my wife, but to no avail. Now, she says, quite rightly in my opinion, that when all else fails, might is right. So, dear, I'm bigger and stronger than you, so what's it to be? Agreement or humiliation? The
you
choice is yours.
You think you've defeated me, don't you? Well, think again. If you lay one finger on me, you beast, I shall have the police onto you for common assault and wife beating.
Ah.
I should think a person of your gentle sensibilities wouldn't be able to stand the humiliation of being known as a common wife-beater. Nah! What do you make of that?
Well, I think you're quite right, my dear, but I think you'd find that the constabulary would require witnesses to the event.
Well, there's plenty of witnesses here.
I don't see any.
I can't believe it. Do you mean you would all stand there whilst I am abused? Me, a poor, defenceless woman, whose only crime is to love her family and want the best for them?
In a nutshell, yes.
It's for your own good, Mummy. You really must just stop bullying people.
Me? Bully? When have I ever bullied anybody?
I really think
Be quiet, Roland. Don't interrupt me. I've told you that before. I don't know what the matter is with you today. How dare you go against me? I thought I could rely on you. Has the world gone mad?
No, it's just you.
You. I'll kill you.
Stop her, somebody. Get her off me.
Stop her.
I'm sorry, Marjorie, but I did warn you.
Do you have Roland?
Stuart, say something!
I think your dad's doing quite enough already.
All right! Do your worst! I'm just a poor, defenceless woman surrounded by vicious hooligans. I am prepared, Roland. Do your worst.
Come on, Roland, what are you waiting for?
It's no good, I couldn't do such a thing.
Well, give it here, I'll do it.
No, you won't! You won't, there'll be no more violence here today. The wedding day should be a time for happiness and celebration, not arguments and aggression.
I knew he couldn't go through it. You all know I'm right. I forgive you all. That's what mothers do.
Mummy, have you thought about why he couldn't do it?
Well, because as usual, he knew he was in the wrong. Isn't that correct, Roland?
Well, not really, my dear. You see, despite everything, your naturally bossy and bumptious ways, I've always loved you. That's why I can never hurt you.
Oh, Daddy! I knew you couldn't do it. You've always been the rock in our family. A gentle rock, but still.
They don't make you a saint for this, mate. I don't. There's no justice in the world.
Well, I don't know why you're all congratulating him. After all, I won again, didn't I?
Do you really think so? I don't.
Well, of course I did. He couldn't go through with his wicked scheme, could he?
But do you remember why he couldn't go through with it?
Who cares? Couldn't do it. That's all that counts.
He said it's because he loves you.
As amazing as that is.
Oh, shut up, Steve! Does it mean nothing to you that he couldn't hurt you because he loves you?
Well, yes, but he's always saying things like that. He's been saying things like that ever since we got married. Come to think of it, before we got married as well. After a time, you just stop noticing. I suppose I take his love for granted. Roland, is that correct?
I'm afraid so, my love, but it doesn't make it any less true, does it?
And you really think that I am a bossy and shrewd?
Hallelujah, she finally understands. Yeah, no, shut up, Steve.
Roland, do you really believe all those things?
I'm afraid so, my love. You do tend to have a large number of irritating traits.
And have I been bullying and bossy with the arrangements for this wedding?
Oh, yes.
I was talking to my husband, thank you. Roland?
I'd say, my dear, that you've been unbearable.
Well, all I can say is to you all is I'd better change my ways, hadn't I? Now, we've got a wedding to go to, and if we're going to make all the changes the bride and groom want, we've not got a lot of time. First of all, Stephen, you will be best man. Roland, take that suit off and put on something you like. Becky, my love, your hairdresser and the rest of the bridesmaids are waiting to make you even more beautiful, if that's possible. Judith, you go with her. Roland, you go with the girls. I'll go and get the cake, and I'll see you all at the church in a couple of hours. Well, lots to do, lots to do.
I'm not quite sure I believe what I've just heard there.
Daddy! Thank you. We're so lucky to have you.
So's Mum.
Well, Roland, it seems thanks to you we're going to have a lovely day today.
And you must be relieved, mate.
You're too true. You know, there were times there I didn't think I was ever going to get married. But I have to say, I'm glad you'll be there, by my side.
As I always should have been. Oh.
So, now you're the best man at my wedding, you can bring Sonia.
Oh, now, you know, Roland, you must, was today really worth it?
Oh, well, I mean, like I say, it's been somewhat fraught, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Very fraught. But in the end, most successful.
Yeah, I mean, now I'm sure she knows you're not a man to be trifled with.
Yeah, I'm sure everything will be fine now. She's been well and truly put in her place.
You think so, do you?
Well, hasn't she?
I very much doubt it.
Really?
Well, she'll be contrite for a few weeks, but then she'll gradually start to revert back. She always does.
You mean you've got to go through all this again?
Oh, yeah, every year or so, yeah. But you see, Marjorie's a very strong woman. And, well, that's what I love about her. That's why I married her. In a perverse sort of way, that's what I love about her. She's, well, pretty amazing, really. But every now and again, she just needs calming down for her own good. And in today's case, for everybody else's.
Well, all I can say is that love and marriage are very strange things indeed.
Yeah. As I'm going to be finding out in a couple of hours now.
Oh, I don't think I'll be having the same sort of problems I've had, Stuart.
Won't I?
I don't do very much.
Yeah, now, as I said before, now you're my best man. Are you bringing Sonia?
Yes, well, I've just got to make a miraculous recovery from the lurgy. Just persuade her to put on her best frock and meet me at the church. Mm. But with my enormous sex appeal, I'm sure I can manage this on the trusty phone. Now, if you don't mind clearing off and giving me some privacy.
Oh, I suppose we'd better leave Romeo here to his machinations then, Stuart.
Thanks, Mr. R. I'm not quite sure what mashed potato nations are, but rest assured I shall give up both barrels.
Oh, sure you will, Steele, sure you will.
You know what? I think I'm going to stick around. Listen to old lover boy at work. Maybe I can pick up a few tips.
So, you want some advice from the expert in love, eh? Well, in that case, I can tell you to piss off.
Come on, Roland.
Ah, hello, Sonia. How are you? Hang on a second. Sorry, love. Yeah, hi, gorgeous. Yeah, well, I'm sounding better because, well, I'm feeling better. Yeah, it must have been one of those 24-hour things. Yes, I'm sure I'm feeling okay. So I thought we should go to the wedding.
Yes, yes, I know. I've known him since I was a kid. So I should be there. Especially because I'm the best man.
Good evening, gents, ladies and gents. I just wanted to reiterate exactly what Clive said at halftime about the Bonnie and Clyde, not Bonnie and Clive. We are going to be doing it at Stamford, and we are actually moving into the new modern times by email and stuff like that, with replicas, if you would have thought it. Anyway, if you wanted to be informed, I say, please put your name and address or email address at the back, and we'll inform you nearer the time, September this year. And we will actually inform you as to where you can buy tickets and obviously where the destination is. Also, also wanted to point out that the furniture we've got here tonight has actually been donated to us by the British Heart Foundation. Oh. And it's very kind of them to do it, and considering that they're a charity, they usually accept things, but they've actually given us something, which is really, really nice. So as a part of a thank you for them, I did promise them that we'll put a bucket at the back, and if you have any spare change or anything like that, I really would appreciate a donation to the British Heart Foundation as you leave tonight. And really, I'm glad you enjoyed the show. Thank you very, very much for coming. Have a safe journey home. Thank you all.